profit can't be changed. Because of what? Well, because there is this thing called the law of cause and effect, and also because of impermanence. Because of impermanence, things are impermanence. And also because of dependent origination. Because things can change. The life is not fixed. It's that it can be changed. All we need to know is we need to know how to change it. We need to know the nature of law. And we need to know what are the relevant causes to change. And in order to change that, we must be completely... In order to see how to change our life, we need to be detached, be selfless, to give ourselves a chance to have pure vision. When we have pure vision, then it's easy to see where in our life that goes wrong. In what aspect? What are the causes that goes wrong? And how can we qualify and change it according to the general law? And also we talk about in order to change our life, we must believe that we can change it. If you do not have that belief, then there will be a mental limitation. And then we have a mental limitation, and everything gets limited. If that outside is not possible, then it becomes impossible. So our job is we need to see what is possible as possible, what is impossible as impossible, and we need to get help of Dhamma, the teaching of the Buddha. That's the best way, by the teaching of the Buddha. It is easier through the wisdom of the Buddha. It becomes much easier for us to grasp, to know what is possible, what are the impossibilities, so that we won't waste our time working on what is impossible. It is very important. If we work on what is impossible, no matter how hard we work, we will fail. No matter how hard we work, we will fail. Just like, you know, many long time ago, when I see what happened in Sri Lanka, the LTTE, the falls, and things like that, I already say this cannot sustain. By the rate at the rate they commit the wrong causes, new wrong causes cannot sustain. Even today, if the winning ones, if they do not go according to Dhamma, then peace cannot sustain. In order to sustain peace, they must know. If they want peace, they must know what are the conditions relevant for peace. If they want happiness, we must know what are the relevant factors contributing to happiness. If we don't know, then we work hard, then our heart will eventually fall, will crumble down. That's what happened to the LTTE also. Because they use violence to cause more causes of suffering in order to bring good. If we add more causes of suffering, eventually we cannot. They will suffer. So same in our life also. So I already predicted one day this will happen. How we predict? According to nature, how we know if someone is adding new causes in their life, there's no way. No way they can actually fulfill their wish. Temporarily, yes. But not permanently, but not in a reliable manner. So for our life also, if you look at our life, if you really want to improve our life, then we shouldn't work on the wrong causes. We must know what is possible as possible, what is impossible as what is impossible. And wholesome things never produce good results. And wholesome things always eventually, when it ripens, it will produce good results. So if we go by that, it will be much simpler. And in order to understand the teaching of the Buddha, we need to invoke, sometimes we need a wise man to guide us. Sometimes the teaching in Sutta seems too profound. We cannot understand deeply, so we should guide wise man, wise companion in holy life, then we can understand better. So that's the three conditions. If you, before we want to change our life, all these basic understanding we need to have. If you do not have basic understanding, you just go ahead. You want to change by sheer willpower. But if that willpower doesn't work according to nature, you will fail also. Willpower is not sufficient. You need to know all the relevant factors and nature law and the conditions involved. Then only we can work to improve our life. 那我们之前的讲座里面就讲到，生命是可以改变的，命运是可以改变的，并没有所谓的死定的那个命运。为什么呢？因为生命里面有无常的法则，因为生命里面有因果的法则，因为有无常有因果的法则，还有缘起的法则，我们就可以改变命运。怎么改变？在因上下功夫，只要我们在因调整那个因，那我们因改变了，我们的命运就会改变。那么要如何做呢？那我们也说你需要了解自然界的法则。如果我们不了解自然界的法则，我们不会达到目的，我们不会达到目的。那么要了解自然界的法则，当然最好是通过佛陀的这个的引导，因为佛陀是觉者，告诉了我们自然界的规则。那么通过学佛学法，我们了解自然界的规则过后，我们就会懂得如何运作。这是一点。那我们也想到，这个你要给自己一个超然的、清明的自见，带着一个无我无私的心，心就会看东西、想东西都比较清明，都比较能够看清我们的生命。如果我们连自己眼前的生命都看不清楚，那我们怎么改变生命？你必须先看得清楚，如实的看清你生命里面有些哪一些苦因，有哪一些乐因，有哪一些失败的因，有哪一些成功的因，要看清楚你才可以。可是要看清楚，我们心要清明。如果我们心有很多很多的那一些污染，那我们看得不清楚。那么讲的这个自然界的规则，我们看清楚自然界的规则，我们也看清楚那些因缘，我们就可以开始改变我们的命运。这很重要。其实讲到这个，刚才他给了一个例子，就是你看西兰的那些大女子佛判决，其实好多灵性我就判断他一定会失败，一定会苦，因为他们用的手法是增加苦因。从他的因那边我就知道他的目的，最终眼前可能得意，最终一定要痛苦的，不会有平静，也不会有快乐。今天也一样，就算如果那个胜利的政府军，如果他们不懂得在胜利的时候给自己珍惜这个机会，改变他们的态度方式，好好的为和平经营的话呢，那么将来还是有无限的痛苦。如果他们骄傲，那最终会有无限的痛苦。这个因果是真实不虚，我们常常看因就可以知道这个人他的未来会如何，真的看得出来。为什么呢？因为只要你知道自然界的法则，你就知道什么因带来什么果。那么其实呢，我们也讲到，你必须要改变命运，你要相信你能够改变命运，你要相信。如果你不相信，你给自己增加至少一个思想的极限。如果你没有思想的勇气，那你就会苦。可是这个思想的勇气也要如法，也要符合自然界的规则。但是如果你把可能的看成不可能，你就很难做到。你必须把可能看成是可能。然后你要知道可能为可能，不可能也不可能。然后你要突破这个思想的极限，然后你要开始你就可以去做，给自己的命运注入对的意义，看清。 可能一些要改变。然后我们也说到，你在这方面最好是经过佛陀的智慧，因为佛陀是我们圆满的觉者，所以通过佛陀的智慧，我们可以了解自然界的规则，了解怎么样的，怎么可能，怎么不可能，来了解怎么改变我们的命运。那么问题是，佛陀的智慧在经里面也蛮多的，不容易，一般上的不容易了解，所以我们需要有智者，需要找出什么是智慧的人，要找出有智慧的智者，让智者引导我们，引导我们去了解佛陀的这个教法。那么在这方面呢，这个佛陀的经里面有讲到呢，这个要讲这个智者。有一回，阿难尊者他来问佛陀，他说：“我觉得，佛陀，我觉得我现在可能把你们呢，有一次，佛陀来到阿难尊者那边，在阿难尊来佛陀那边休息，佛陀阿难尊者跟佛陀讲。”우파다미랑반테라마차야스야리랑칼리아나미타타칼리아나사하야타칼리아나삼바완완카타티이바보는뭐이다에왕우타한에저희거다이다사카라메와히라나나다라마차리앙야리랑칼리아나미타타칼리아나사하야타칼리아나삼바완카타カリアナンタセタマランダビクフロパティカンカンカリアナサハヤスカリアナサンパマカサアリアンアタンギカンマカンバウェサティアリアンアタンギカンマカンバウリカリサティ。这是什么意思呢？阿难尊者来见佛陀，跟佛陀问：“阿爹，我觉得这个梵行生活不出家生命。”那么这个医疗有那个善友啊，医疗善友有智慧的朋友，有智慧的朋友啊，善友，那么跟这个善友相处呢，实在是我们的这个梵行生活修行生命的一半一半。然后佛陀说：“阿难，别这么说，别这么说，这样这个呢，梵行生命啊，这个亲近的善友跟善友相处，实在是这个梵行生命的全部。为什么呢？因为呢，一个善友亲近善友呢，你可以接触到八正道；那么一个能够亲近善友学到这个八正道的人呢，最终学得什么修行的人呢，他最终呢有可能呢，是提升他的生命。所以这个善友是很重要的。So about regarding this many from wise friend and wise company, one time the Venerable Ananda he went to the Buddha, he said this: Upadhamidam Vante Brahmacharyasa Yaridam Kalyana Mitata Kalyana Sahayata Kalyana Sambhavakata. And then the Buddha replied, Evam Udaham, Mahi Evam Ananda, Mahi Evam Ananda, Sakalam Evam Hidam Ananda, Brahmacharyam, Yahidam Kalyana Mitata, Kalyana Sahayata, Kalyana Sambhavakata, Kalyana Mita Setam Ananda, Vikuno Pati Kam Kam, Kalyana Sahayasa, Kalyana Sambhavakasa, Aryam Atantikam Magam, Bhave Sati Aryam Atantikam Magam, Bhavulikari Sati.What does it mean? Another Ananda came and talked to the Buddha, the Bhante. In my understanding, this life, this Brahmacharya life, this spiritual life, regarding this spiritual life, meeting the wise friend, wise companion, association with wise companion is half ofthis spiritual life. Then the Buddha said, no, please don't say so, Ananda, don't say so, Ananda. meeting wise company, association with wise company is the whole of this spiritual life. So from there you see how important is this. And the Buddha actually said, meeting the Buddha is the Buddha is the best wise company in this world. So it's very important, meeting wise company, because of wise company, we come to know what know these four noble truths. Because of knowing four noble truths, the Buddha said, there's a hope of fulfilling our cultivation. So today, when the Most Venerable Bhava Sera, my preceptor, when I consult him about this sutta, when he explained to me, of course he explained more thoroughly for our talk, I would go so deep. So when he explained, I felt really deep, have a very deep feeling about that. I find meeting actually changed my life completely. In fact, if I met him early in my teenage, I wouldn't waste time for other things. I would have been marked much earlier. Instead of becoming my age of 28, I would have had to become a monk at the age of in my teenage. That would be much better. Such a revolution he brought to my life because of meeting Sera. Early on, we just aspire, we were thinking, when those days I made aspiration, how nice if I meet someone who can teach me to practice. If only I can meet someone who will teach me practice up to neither perception nor non-perception. Oh, it would be so wonderful. But actually, the Buddha Sera can teach you so much more than that. Things, the old thing, the wonderful thing, we read in the path of verification in Visuddhi Magga, how Sera can just teach us exactly in such a profound and deep meditation. So I felt, oh, it's wonderful, you know. If not because of him, I find my monk life maybe just ordinary. But because of meeting Pao Sera, we can experience so much wonderful Dhamma. The whole thing about Abhidhamma then seems to be so theoretical. That's only. But because of Sera, he teaches how to experience them, to know them by our own experience, to prove them. It's wonderful. In fact, much more to learn from him. So I find, when I read about this sutta, Kalanamita, really. Without meeting Pao Sera, I find, my life will be just lack of luster, lack of light. But because of meeting Pao Sera, my life changed. So wonderful, so beautiful, everything, what the Buddha said, becomes so hopeful, realizable, experienceable. Things about, you don't need to believe in rebirth anymore. You don't need to believe in the law of cause and effect anymore. He is the one who teaches. He teaches the students to experience, to prove it. Then you know the Buddha's teaching is correct. You don't need to believe in Buddha's teaching. You just know this is true. How wonderful it is. Meeting Kalyanamita really is a whole one. Meeting Kalyanamita, meeting wise company, wise friend, is really the whole of spiritual life. In fact, not only spiritual life, our life in general. By meeting wise friends, we can change our life. We really can change our life. Because why? Because wise friends are friends that are guides, are mentors, that actually guide us to live according to nature and law, to live according to Dhamma. And by invoking the power of Dhamma, our life change, our life can transform. It's so wonderful. It's so wonderful. So, 说到这个善友，今天我想我的祭司，我曾经启示这个善友经的时候，他给我讲解，但他给我讲解比较深了，但是为了今天的讲座，我只讲的不能讲的太深，但是。 当我读这个经的时候，我很震撼的。其实那是感触特别深，特别是在下面的起相，感触特别的深刻。
没有找到真理，那么他还是很恳切的要寻找真理。他来世，他
还是因为他那个倾向仰慕裸体身，结果还是又想着裸体身，很自然的就会跑去出家做裸体身。那么又一辈子裸体的少欲之主是比较清高的一点，可是还是没有找到自己那一辈子，那么那一次他就比较智慧，他很肯去那些，因为我们要有智慧的人引导我，让我们要有智慧的人引导我的事，让我有智慧的人给我指导我这个真理。那还好这个缘让他来世也投身做人的时候，投身做人的时候呢很自然，那个时候也刚好有那个三千年有佛出现在世间，他继续跟佛的修法，修了自禅的观禅，秘密就从那一次开始，就一直都在善法之中，一直在善法之中。所以不是这么容易的，有些时候即使是两个肯去追求真理，如果你没有遇到一个明灯，一个真正能够指引你的人，你就错过了。其实是你很肯去，像这个人一样，很肯去追求真理，还是找不到，一丝一丝找不到。这个还是很真心的寻求真理的人。所以，如果我们能够遇到善缘，我们要珍惜，能够引导我们从正路的，我们要珍惜。所以，咖喱比上面下的 story。Real song. Long time ago, there was a tree deva. Tree deva. And then, in the forest, he was thinking, seeing those fire worshippers. He admired those fire worshippers. Because at that time, there's no wise ever said. People, these fire worshippers are just the only truth seeker. The rest of the people are indulging in.All essential pleasures. So to this tree deva, admire this fire worshipper. So he was thinking, oh, how nice. These people are so sincere, so true, searching for truth. So he thought they have truth. Without knowing that this fire worshipper knew nothing about truth. So because of that inclination, somehow after passing away, he was reborn as a human being, and he actually joined the fire and became one of the fire worshippers.A whole life of worship fire. But what can you get by worshipping fire? Nothing. But because of his sincerity, so that's not really bad. Huh? After all, that was the best thing he could find at that time. He couldn't find any better practice at that time. So, not very serious wrong view, but mainly just sincerely searching for truth. So, when he passed away, he was reborn as human being again.But in that line, he actually admired, because again, at the back of his mind, he actually admired his naked as a pig. But he didn't change immediately that line. He still continued, very persistent, very strong determination. He finished his fire worship until the end of his life. But next time, again, he became a human being. Again, he was a desire for searching for truth, so strong. This person very strange.Is a strong desire searching for truth from life to life, always search for truth. So this time he was searching for truth again, so he joined the naked ascetics. He became one of the naked ascetics, whole life walking naked here and there. But no truth again. So before he passed away, he made an aspiration behind the infusion, be able to meet wise people who can guide me to find truth.To find higher Dhamma. And with that aspiration, truly now that aspiration works well. You know? Next life, again he was searching for truth. And he was ascetic. And then while he was ascetic, one day he met the Buddha. At that time, the Buddha appeared in the world. So he met the Buddha, he learned Samatha and Vipassana from the Buddha. And after that, Samatha and Vipassana training, from that life onwards,He was always moving from light to light. Always. So how wonderful. Just by meeting Kalyana with a wise friend, especially the greatest wise friend in the world, the Buddha, so he changed his life. This is the Dharma that changed our life. This is Dharma. So, how wonderful it is. So, talking about changing our life, then we have asked this question. Very often, when people believe in fate, they think, well, this is so much suffering I have to. The fortune teller say, I have to suffer this much, this much, this year, after this year. Then we give up. But maybe the fortune teller may be correctly diagnosed and saying that, oh, you have this much of karma. But do we really need to suffer that much? Then we need to understand our suffering. How much will suffering really happen because we just cannot avoid it? And how much suffering occur because we do not know how to avoid it? What are the suffering that can be avoided? What are the suffering that cannot be avoided? We need to know. This is a quote. Yes, so little quote. 我们要问一个问题，在改变生命里面，是否我们生命里面所受的苦是我们一定要受的？有哪一些苦是我们必然无可逃避的？有哪一些苦是其实可以免的？如果我们要改变生命，那我们想改变生命就是想少一点苦，多一点快乐，对不对？那我们就要问这个问题。 那么，其实，如果你是真研究生，我们为了我们的业所受的苦是一部分，我们为了我们业所带来的那种模式，那个 pattern 所受的苦，所造继续的造恶业所受的苦，那是另一回事，要分得清楚。 We need to differentiate two things. One is the suffering that we have to work for, we have to pay for, we have to face because of our karma. And also, we need to differentiate another type of suffering. The suffering due to our karmic pattern. Because of our karma created a various kind of pattern in our mind, in our character. And that pattern makes us continue to add in causes of suffering to our life. And that pattern makes us continue to commit wrong things and continue to react to things in the wrong way and continue to perpetuate suffering and causes of suffering. This we have to differentiate. And if we differentiate this, then we will realize that so much of our suffering can be reduced. So, in a 分辨出我们业所带来的苦和业的模式所带来的苦，这是很重要的。如果我们能够分辨出来，那我们会发现到生命里面很多的苦，实在是可以免除的。 甚至有时候我们可以说，可能有些时候我们造下的业无可逃避的业，可能是五分的业。可是为了这五分的业，那个业成熟的时候，我们受苦果的时候，因为我们那个错误的模式，比如说嗔恨的模式，不经过心，不冷静思考去反应，去抗议的那种模式。 或者是他的模式，或者是一时的模式，或者是激动冲动的模式。那个模式让我们，那个模式也是受我们的那个过去的那个习气啊、业啊，或者影响。如果这个模式会让我们继续的做出错误的决定、错误的反应、受苦的时候呢，在苦果成熟的时候，我们继续的造苦，所以我们的苦就没完。如果我们能够看清这一点，我们看清啊，这是我的苦。 可能这个只是我忍一忍就可以过去的事情。以前我不会忍，我很冲动。现在我就冷静。以前我不会在苦的事情发生的时候呢，用智慧 发挥出自己的智慧。现在我不要，我去等。以前我在苦的时候呢，我会马上反应，我很相信自己的判断。现在不要，现在苦的时候，感受不好的时候，不要相信自己。你发现了，你改了那个模式，可能那个苦一下子就过去了。以前可能一件小小的事情，你会破坏，彻底的破坏人际关系。现在你遇到同样的事情，你忍一忍，这个是苦，要冷静，冷静一下，不要感受不清明，感受不自然，不自然的时候，不要相信自己的感受，不要相信自己的判断，等一等，然后等心情进入平和的时候，对自己对别人都能够有慈悲的时候，我在思考我的问题，在想怎么对事情做出正确有智慧如法的反应。单单这一个改变，你的生命就变了，你就发现到很多很多的苦，以往你受了很多很多的苦，现在甚至少了很多很多。以往一件事情就搞得不可收拾，搞僵，现在忍一忍就过去了，而且能够用很好的智慧去发挥，去面对，去判断，去度过，真的。所以单单这一点，单单这个感，你看了业，过去当然也可能造成人家来侮辱你啊，阻碍你啊，破坏你啊，诽谤你啊。那现在你的反应，因为你现在有种佛法的有智慧的，你不要再活出那个旧的模式，你不要再活出那种嗔恨啊、记恨啊、报复的那种业的模式，就告诉你忍一忍，消消业障。现在你用法的模式去反应，马上你就看到你的生命就不同。过去你种了一次箭的时候，你抓上那个箭不放，抓上那个箭不放，现在你让那个箭在你心里面舒畅，所忍受的痛苦，现在你不要，箭射是快快的就排除掉，拔出来就好。以前你受到人家受到不好的人的侮辱的时候，你就记恨在心，久久你就苦了，苦上一个月还恨人家，甚至苦很久的，是恨人家一辈子。现在，哎呀，算了，宽容人家，人家也是苦，可能人家为我的业气反应，我的罪过，因为我的业成熟，他也没有足够的正念，他对我的业气反应，甚至你可能会想，他可能是我的业的受害者。所以你想转心转移过来的时候，他是一个定力不够的人，正念不够的人，所以我的恶业冒起来的时候呢，他不能同意我的恶业起反应，他替我演坏人的角色。所以他也够可怜，所以你心转一转，反正你可以对人家起慈悲心，马上你发现你的生命就不同。单单一个心念的转变，以往那个旧的思考模式、旧的说话模式、旧的反应做事的模式，你一转过来，你发现到你的苦大大的减少，减少很多很多的，这个就改变的事。这位宝宝心经往来， When we know, we can differentiate what is a karma, karma result, and then what is a karmic pattern, then very easy. By changing our pattern, our behavior, our tendencies, the way we respond to things, the egoistic way, the default way, then by recognizing this is the pattern caused by our past,tendency, accumulation. When in the past, when we accumulate the karma, we also accumulate tendencies. That tendencies come with us all the life of life. Like some people have anger tendency, greed tendency, jealous tendency, all sorts of tendencies. Okay? It forms our character. But if we understand, then now we understand this, you know, this karmic pattern is law.It's not wholesome, it's not in accordance with nature, law, the good part. Then we think this is against the Dharma, against the wholesome Dharma, then we must change. So, suppose your past karma today caused you some misfortune. Some people rob you, or cause you angry, scold you, slander you, whatever.And then if you realize this is just my vipaka, the result of my karma, I should just tolerate it. Of course, if I can call it, at least there's another story. But I should tolerate it. I don't need to get angry. Do we need to create more causes of suffering here and now? By doing that, I really we accept it and then tolerate it. Or even forgive the person, thinking that this person maybe a victim of my karma, because my karma is ripening, and that person is not mindful. Sometimes people, because of their lack of mindfulness, lack of wisdom, they respond to our bad karma. When my karma, our bad karma ripens, they respond to our bad karma. So when they respond to the bad karma, our bad karma, they treat us, regard us badly. So because of that, we suffer. So you can think like that, you can even have compassion for that person. How beautiful. While I'm exhausting my karma, while he's helping me to exhaust my bad karma, he's accumulating new bad karma. How beautiful. So by thinking like that, you can have a lot of compassion. Instead of reacting in angry way, you can react in with forgiveness, with compassion. And just this alone, you can see how much change it can cause to your life. How much change. Previously, something happened, the things prolonged, destroying the relationship. A small thing, because a small thing, you suffer for a long time. Now, you no longer suffer that much. Immediately recover. Immediately recover. So, how much is it? So much difference. In the past, suppose you get an arrow shoot into you. You have the tendency to hold on to the arrow, you have to prove. You have to keep it there. You remember, I get this arrow, this person shoot me this arrow, I want to keep it there. I want to remember it. And then because of that, you suffer a long time. This is a simile for anger or whatever harm people cause to you. And you have to remember, you have to hold grudge. That is just like holding on to the arrow. And because of that, the arrow lasts a long time in our heart, and we suffer. And now you realize it's not worthy. Well, after all, this thing happened because of my vipaka. And the result of my karma, because I've done something unwholesome in the past, let me really accept it and tolerate it. Of course, I'm not saying that you cannot call the police. You please, by all means. You can take rightful action, please. But we need to create new causes of suffering for ourselves, for the sake of other people's mistakes and defilements, for other people's evil. So with that, you notice that now we are no more this. You no longer suffer for people's words, people's actions for so long already. In the past, we hold grudge for a few days, even 1 month, even for whole life. Now you don't need to suffer. Give so much suffering to yourself. They say, well, let it be. Okay, I just suffer. Okay? Just forgive it and let go. And immediately concentrate on what you can do, what you are capable of doing, what are the relevant conditions, the relevant things for your upliftment of your life. And if you can do like that, and you see so much change, just these things alone, just these few things, you see so much change you can bring to your life. So much change. You see, when we see happiness, we are saying about a happy experience of life. By saying unhappiness, unhappy life, we are saying unhappy experiences of life. And we can change our life, whether it is happy or not, we can change it. We can change our experience of life by changing how we take life, how we regard life. Whether we regard life with wise attention, or we regard life with unwise attention. Whether we look at life, we regard life experiences with Dhamma, or we regard life experiences with Adhamma. You can decide. So, by having Dhamma knowledge, by learning Dhamma, we transform our mind, we transform the way we regard our experiences, and how we experience things, the way we experience things, our perception, our feeling, our attention. By changing that, we change our life. Whether we still get robbed, we still get scolded, we still get slandered or not, that we cannot say exactly. But at least we can change the way we respond to things. Then, just by doing that, we definitely change our fate. But more than that, we actually can change the external experience, external phenomena that come to us by changing the causes, by changing our present karma that we are creating. We can actually change. Suppose if we are more kind to people, we practice a lot of loving kindness, compassion, appreciating joy and equanimity to all other beings, you find that not only here and now you change your life, not only here and now you change your mind, and not only here and now you change your experiences, you also change your encounter with people. You find that people respond to you better because of your true heart, your love, your loving kindness, compassion, appreciating joy, and equanimity. Suppose this is body, loving kindness everybody knows, compassion everybody knows, to benefit. But this just like this appreciating joy. You can appreciate people's good qualities, you can appreciate people's success, you wish people success and gain and wealth and good things not be lost. Just by wishing people like that, you find that you attract. Because sincerely, selflessly, wish people to be successful. You are not jealous with people being more successful than you. You can rejoice for other people's good qualities. Then you realize that it made you more capable to be a leader. People trust you even more. Capable people tend to flock to you and come to you. Why? Because you are not jealous of their ability. Because of that quality helps you to help other people to bring out their potentials. And if you are a leader that can help people to uplift their life, you don't hinder people's potentials and ability. You actually help people to uplift their life and help people to use their potential even more efficiently, even more completely, naturally. You don't long for leadership, leadership comes to you. You don't crave to be, but leadership comes to you. It is good to have leadership because those who have leadership, they are in a better position to perform much greater merit. Because that merit is not performed by you alone, it's performed by the whole team. When the whole team perform merit, and being a leader, that bring other people, help other people to use their potentials, your life change. Your other people's life change. Because you help people to improve their quality of life, and your life also become much better. You accumulate so much good merits if you are a real, effective leader. But nowadays people crave leadership. They want to sit on top without being really sincerely working for the welfare of others. Without being actually capable of working for the welfare of others. They say they want to work for the welfare of others, but they try to beat down other people, more capable people. This is no real leader. A real leader is not a leader. They must be really sincere and thinking, if this person is more capable of me than me, then let this person take the main major role. I will take a secondary role. I just want other people to benefit from, to get real benefit. By doing that, the second man will perform much better than he be a first top man. Really? Yeah, actually, people perform better than this. People don't understand that. That's why people create leadership and compete for leadership. Real leaders, they don't compete for leadership. Leadership down on them, come to them. So you see, it is good. It is good. Huh? Just like this appreciating joy alone, it really enhances the leadership of a person. What more to say about other qualities I've done? This is only one example I give. So 讲到这个改变自己的事，当你懂得依法如实去改变你的生命的时候，你发现生命就大大的改变。因为通过改变有两种方式，你改变你的生命：一，你改变你自己对生命的经验的方式，你所谓的快乐和痛苦。我们在改变生命，就是要改变一个更快乐、更成功的生命，对不对？我们不要苦的生命，我们不要不快乐的生命。我们要得到更快乐、更好的生命。 我们两方面来看，一方面是你当下只要你转你的心，用更如法的方法，更有法的心去对待你眼耳鼻舌身意的一些经验，用如理作意，有智慧的作意，有法的作意，作意是什么？注意方式。那么现在像你用好的思考方式去面对你生命的经验，你有点苦，你想这个我消消业障，我的业障会轻一点。所以这些如理作意改变方式，那么当下你发现你就坏了，当下你的生命就改变了。这个是改变自己去经验事物的方式，这个肯定能够做到。苦来你想消消业障，忍一忍，我磨练一下，我培养我自己的心力和意志力，那么一更耐，那么那个是好的。另一种呢，其实它不只是如此改变生命而已，这个你说你自己想，它不是真实的，外面的经验没有改变。有些人还是希望外面的经验改变，你才是希望别人对你好，也会的。如果你比如说以前常常会承认别人啊什么，现在你完全慈悲的方式对待别人，你发生了你的人际关系就改变，慈悲喜舍，完完全全你的那个 EQ emotional intelligence， 你的那个情绪智慧改变了，你发现你的生命就改变了，整个生命就改变了，你的生命的经验就改变了。但你不只是如此，它真的带来外面的改变，你的慈心带来的改变，我相信你们都知道。当你更有爱心带来的时候，人家会更信任你，更喜欢你，你的人际关系会更好。你这个真心更无私的心带来的时候，你的人际关系会更好，更一心，人家会更加觉得你是一个更好的依靠，有人会朝你帮忙，这是好的。当然有些时候最好会有危机，有危机你先过来找我，我就麻烦，不会，你一帮人再多，人家有麻烦找你，实在是我们的福气，我们有机会做更好的功德，人家信任我们才会有麻烦找上我们，真的，这个是悲心的力量。好，我就举另一个例子，大概一个喜心的力量就不同。喜心是什么？喜心，喜无量心是你祝福别人，因为别人所拥有的成就、财富、好不会失去。这个喜无量心要对峙的是我们的妒忌心。你看他的这个就可以搞很大的改变，他完完全全改变一个人的能力。什么能力呢？很多了，我们讲其中一个，就是领导能力。一个妒忌心很强的人，不忌财的人，看到人家有才干，看到人家比自己成功就妒忌的人，他只有继续的，很奇怪，他就是不会有什么影响力，他的领导能力就大大的大杀奉行的，他比较差。可是如果一个人他有广大的心量，他欣赏别人的力量，他帮助别人开发他们的潜质，他帮助别人活得更好，帮助别人成功，然后他制造机会给别人发挥，你会发现他这样子的人呢，他会自然而然的，他不追求做领导，领导找上他，领导能力找上他，领导的地位也会找上他。真的，为什么有才干的人也会找上他，喜欢被他领导？为什么呢？因为他的存在，他不会妒忌人才，他不会妒忌才干，他不会说要压迫人家的才干，他自己能够要站在那个位置上，要把别人点下来，不会的，因为他的心欣赏别人的美，欣赏别人的好，随喜别人的成就，所以也因为有这样子广大的心，他自己会更有成就的。看他这个喜无量心，从妒忌到随喜，懂得喜悲，懂得自己喜无量心，能够随喜别人的成就，能够希望别人的成就才干所得到的一些好不会失去，那么很自然的，他的纯真的心就会给他带来自然的一种引导，领导的力量，这是很重要的。那么一个人如果有领导才干，那他有什么好处呢？现在很多人只是为了名利，他们是争取领导，那么争取领导是没有需要，如果有人可以做得比我们更好，那 那我们何必我们不用积极跟人家真正做的让人家做。真正好的领导人，如果他看到有别人比他更有才干的话，他不会要做第一位，他要做第二位，让人家做第一位。真的，其实他如果那么做的话，他会发挥得更好，他自己会比他自己做第一把交椅还要好的。真的，如果你看到有一个人比你更有才干，你让他做第一把交椅，你做第二把交椅，你那个第二把交椅做得更有意思。所以真正那么如果一个人他有领导才干，他就会很好，他如果单单想行善多，他会做很多很多好事。为什么呢？你带着别人一起走向成功，带着别人一起成就，你给别人机会，给别人机会发挥，那你做的功德实在是很殊胜，很殊胜。因为你不只是一个人做个人的功德，你是带动着别人制造机会，让别人也成就他们的功德，那你的功德是殊胜的。比如说如果你学佛，你会制造机会给别人也来学佛，鼓励别人也来行行善知识，鼓励别人也得到法的好处，不只是我自己得到听消消就好，你会让别人知道，制造机会给别人也来学到法。如果你能够这样做的话，那你已经在扮演一个默默领导的角色。如果你因为你的美德，你的慈悲喜舍，让别人信任你，愿意随着你的指引来去学法，来去行进善知识，那么他所做的一切的善行，你有 commission 的。你就像那个MV 的弟弟，就 commission， 是的。所以这是一个例子而已哦。所以我们不贪求领导，可是如果我们真的有那种力量，让我们行善的时候是一把抓的串起来，那是非常好的。这就是一个例子。所以你看佛法能够改变我们的生命多少呢？单单一个慈悲喜舍，你只是一个天天培养慈悲喜舍，你的生命就改变，你的人际关系就改变，你的生活就改变，甚至你的事业都会改变。真的，好运会找上你，善运会找上你，你能够转恶缘为善缘，你会积很多善缘。So just this body, if you only can practice this loving kindness, compassion, appreciating joy, and this equanimity, you can see that how your good life can just change. Your experience of life, your career, your business, more people tend to trust you and associate with you. Good luck will come to you. You can change bad relationship to good relationship.And you can develop a lot of good relationships with people. More and more and more. So, and then life changes. Everything changes.